Well, I also think that they realized that Jack was going on a very big musical trip and that they wanted to go on it with him. They really did. He worked for everybody, from white guys, black guys, big companies, little companies. It was like the Wrecking Crew. They worked for everybody because everybody wanted him. I had nothing to do with it because, other than writing with Jack and essentially waiting to see what he was going to do with the arrangements, which really are what made it blossom. I mean, I could hum and play chords, and then he would make magic happen. And that's what he was. He was a magic guy. But then he had a falling out with the label, and they wanted another recording, but the producer, Jimmy Bone, wouldn't produce it. So Jack went into United with the guys, and he did a recording called, we called it at the time, The Blow Up. I changed the title to Surf Finger, as in Gold Finger, because it sounds like a James Bond thing. It's a knockout. Jack was the artist and the conductor, and he and I wrote it, and it was done at United, and Jack pretty much had to do it on his own. He asked me to go and sit in the booth, but I did. But Eddie Brackett was the magic guy there. But all I will tell you is that that should have been his biggest accomplishment as a single recording artist, and it never even got out. Someone, to this day I do not know who, took that recording to Capitol, someone at Capitol, and they recorded it with David Rose before they could put it out. And they wouldn't release this record. Warner Brothers, rightfully so, was incensed. And they accused this one of doing it, and that one of doing it, and me of doing it, and someone. And to this day, I do not know who took that record up there. So that was a great adventure. And then after that, you know, Jack didn't keep friends very long, and it got a little. He got very, very involved in a lot of stuff, and life changed.